Welcome to the webcast demonstrating new features of MetaEdit Plus 5.1. MetaEdit 5.1 brings several new features to functionality, usability, scalability, integration, and embedding MetaEdit Plus. And in this webcast, we focus on those dealing with functionality and usability in modeling editors, in metamodeling tools, and in generator development. Let's start with new features that modelers most often see. Sidebar comes with a hierarchical property sheet. It reduces the use of dialogs and makes some of the editing actions faster. Here on the left, you will see the hierarchical property sheet, and it allows viewing elements, but also in-place editing like changing the name and also manipulating larger hierarchies. Like for example, for this ball class, we could add attributes and add their names and change the properties. Still, the dialog-based approach is supported at the same time, and there are also options to show how large the property sheet on the left or right should be. The property sheet is not only for objects, but also for relationships, roles, graphs, and all other MetaEdit elements. Editors like matrix, table, and diagram have several enhancements improving functionality and usability. In addition to the new sidebar with hierarchical property editing, there's also possibility to have a live check be optional. So we can choose here elements to be shown what kind of checkings we would like to show and trace from the live check back to the model element. There's also reconnect. So if a relationship has some properties, we don't need to delete the relationship and add the properties again. We can do a reconnect and update the model accordingly. And now the live check shows that the model is correct. There's also active info, so if you choose an element, we can see at the bottom the actions that can be done. And there's also drag with the group. So if we add here a room, let's call it the burner room, and then we can edit the whole room with all the devices inside it. And then if you can also move the other elements inside there, they become also part of this larger group now. Another new feature with MetaEdit 5.1 is movable ports. A typical situation is that the location of the port is fixed in the perimeter on the left or right, in and out ports, like over here, and they can't be moved by the user. But now we can change the meta model and update this function definition, go to the symbol editor and see here the templates. Here is the template for out ports. And the template has now possibility to allow moving of ports on, and perhaps you also want that the labels can be moved as well, so we can put movable ports for them as well. And once the meta model is saved, then we can go back to the modeling and start dragging and moving these lines. So this way you can add support for movable ports for your existing languages. MetaEdit Merl also allows to reorganize the ports automatically based on the connections made. So here we make a connection between two ports. I'll add here a couple of them. And now when we move these functions, also the ports get recalculated and they position moved so that there's a minimum number of crossing lines. And this function is done with the Merl script. Language developers get several new features with MetaEdit 5.1, making language definition easier and also giving more power. To make language definition easier, there's a set of tools here, and one aspect is symbol library. So you can use symbol library to reuse common symbols or use some already included in our MetaEdit repository. So you can go and find and edit any of these or modify them. And if we, for example, go and edit this, we can update existing library symbols. And these library symbols can not only be edited for your needs, but you can also import them to your library. You can import existing bitmaps or vector graphics to your library. And this way, MetaEdit Plus allows to make you faster, nicer looking languages by reusing existing graphics. There are also new metamodeling constraints and for ports, for instance. So here we add a new connection from a port between two ports. And currently MetaEdit allows to create such a connection, but then at the light check pane, it shows that they are of different type. The other is analog and other is digital. So the model should be corrected. But we may also add a port constraint, making this impossible to create. So we go to the MetaModel tool. So here's the hardware component language that we are using. And here we go to the constraints tab. And now we can add new constraints for port connectivity. So we give a port constraint. And here we can choose from the MetaModel to which kind of object is related. So now it's related to the hardware ports. And now we say that all these hardware ports and pins must be same type. So analog and analog or digital to digital. So once the MetaModel update is changed and we create this kind of connection again, now MetaEdit should not allow to do that because of this constraint. Okay, they are not the same type, but we can go now and update the model and change this port from digital to be analog. And then after the change, we could try to do the connection again. And now MetaEdit should allow to create this because the port constraint passes. So now we can create the connection this way. New version allows creating richer languages that include read-only properties, hidden properties, and UUID properties, ensuring that instances have unique identifier outside MetaEdit too. Let me illustrate this by creating a bus concept here. And for this bus concept, we would like to add a unique identifier. So we go to the MetaModel and add here a new property. And this property can be called like a unique ID. And its data type is now selected to be UUID base 64. And if we add this change to the MetaModel, this bus will get immediately unique ID. We can also make this read-only by changing the local name starting with underscore. So if we accept the MetaModel change and go to see the bus concept now, the bus has now unique ID, but it's read-only. We can't change it. We can also hide these properties from the modelers, from the dialogs, but make them still available for the code generator. So we can go back to the MetaModel and put a double underscore on the local name. And if we accept the change and go to the bus again, now we can't anymore see the unique ID, but it's still there and generators can access, but we don't need to show it for the modelers, so we can hide things. There are also other features on generator development side that are new. There are new commands for things like selecting a file with the file browser, generating hyperlinks to the generated output that are visible here in the generator editor. Then we have also updated the existing generators and also made possible to have an icons, for instance. Here you can see icon for each generator, and these icons are then visible in the toolbar if you decide to make the generator accessible via toolbar. And we also have updated existing generic reports here in the supertype called graph, which is a supertype for all your languages. Here you can see existing generators that have been updated and which you can reuse for all of other languages, like for example here on the metrics side. Collaboration in language definition allows several persons create languages at the same time, the MetaModels, the generators, and also use them at the same time in an agile manner. So usually several persons may edit the MetaModel, and now with the new version, there can be different collaboration levels on security levels and metamodeling rights. For instance, on the metamodeling rights, we can give access rights for metamodeling for GIM and GIL too. And then there's also security level. For example, do we only allow one person to be at a time in the repository, or can there be only one person who is doing the metamodeling, or one person in a project, or are there even one metamodeling right for each language concept? So this kind of collaboration is mandatory when using integrated languages. So different persons can focus on different parts, or as in often in smaller cases too, one focus on language, the second on generator, and third on modeling. This capability allows users create quickly languages and generators and get them tested in a most agile manner. The other new features and improvements are like integration with versioning tools, Git, SVN, ID extensions. And as always, when updating the new MetaEdit, your current models will automatically open and work in the new version. Similarly, and as always, also your current languages and generators will work in the new MetaEdit Plus 5.1. You don't need to recreate anything and you don't lose your work. MetaEdit Plus takes care of it. Thank you for watching the video demonstrating new features of MetaEdit 5.1.